स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर मेकिंग गुड यूज ऑफ योर टाइम एंड टर्निंग योर वीकनेसेस इनटू स्ट्रेंथ्स। लेट्स टॉक अबाउट सोशल स्टडीज क्लास 4, लेसन नंबर 4 दैट वी रेड लास्ट वीक। डिड यू रीड इट थरोली वंस अगेन? यस, आई होप यू माइट हैव डन सो। नाउ टुडे वील बी डूइंग द एक्सरसाइजेस ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। टेक आउट पेज नंबर 31। क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इज फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स। फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स, आई रीड आउट फॉर यू द क्वेश्चन। आंसर्स आई हैव रिटन हियर। अर्लियर वोटिंग वॉज डन थ्रू बैलेट पेपर्स, टूडे इट इज डन थ्रू वोटिंग मशीन। विच वोटिंग मशीन? इलेक्ट्रॉनिक वोटिंग मशीन। सो इन फर्स्ट फिल अप ballot and second one electronic. Now come to question number 2. The protection of a public property is every dash duty. Whose duty? Citizens' duty. So right here, citizens. Third one, never write on the walls of dash building. You may write school building or historical building. Both are correct. Both the answers are correct. Either you can write school or historical. Both are correct. School would be easier for you, so you may write school building. Next one is historical monuments are visited by thousands of tourists from all over the world. Fifth, when you visit a museum, remember to follow the instructions written there. Clear? All the 5 fill-ups we have discussed. Now we'll discuss about the true-false. Exercising the voting power is an important responsibility of every citizen. It's true. Private property means property that is owned by the government. It's false. Private property is not owned by the government, but it belongs to an individual or his family. So it's false. Roads should not be littered with garbage. It's true. Next, if you borrow books from the school library, keep them safely and with care. It's true. Next, damaging historical monuments is a good practice which we should all follow. Is it good to damage all historical monuments? No, not at all. So, no need to do that. It's false. Now come to question number 4. Third we'll be doing in the notebook. They are question answers. So come to the fourth one, which is given in the book. Matchups. These matchups, I'm talking about the next page. Matchups. So the first one is public property. Public property has to be matched with D means owned by the government and belongs to the public in general. Next, save electricity by switching off lights and fans when not in use. Next one, ancient monuments and archaeological sites are Remains Act 1958. It punishes offenses related to damaging of historical monuments. Now come to the fourth one, ballot papers. Ballot papers, which is the answer to it, are now replaced with electronic voting machines. So C is the answer. Archaeological Survey of India, what it is doing? Yes, it protects and maintains पब्लिक प्रॉपर्टी. सो बी इज द आंसर टू इट. आई होप यू ऑल माइट हैव डन दिस इजी क्वेश्चंस. नाउ क्वेश्चन आंसर्स विच आर टू बी डन इन द नोटबुक. लेट्स डिस्कस द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स. Answer to the question number one. What is question number one? Why should an adult citizen vote in election? An adult citizen should vote in elections to choose the right candidate as the leader of a country. Question two. Differentiate between public property and private property. Private property, public property. Private property, it belongs to an individual or his family. Public property, it belongs to the government. Second one, only the owner has the right over it. Every citizen has the right over it. Public property, as it belongs to everybody. All the citizens, like railway stations, roads and all, they belong to everybody. So every citizen has the right over it. Next point is, for public private property, its protection is the responsibility of the owner. Owner has to protect his own property. He has to look after his house, after his mobile, after his bag, and all those things. Public property, its protection is the responsibility of every citizen. So every citizen is responsible for its protection. Clear? I hope this much is clear to you. Next answer. What is the question? How should a good citizen care for public property like roads, railways, parks, etc.? How can you take care of them? A good citizen should take care of roads, railways, and parks in the following ways. First one, he should not damage them by tearing the seats or scribbling on the metallic bodies. Second, he should not litter on the roads. Third, he should not pluck flowers from the parks. Have you all understood this much? Now, question number four. One more point is there for answer three. He must keep the stations and compartments of the trains clean. Cleanliness is also necessary. So this point also you may add to answer 3. Now answer 4. How, question number 4 is, how should you care for your school and public libraries? That you all know. We can take care of our school property and public libraries by keeping these points in mind. Do not break the desks or any other school property. Never write on the walls of the school building. Keep the school campus clean by using dustbins. Save water and electricity. How you can do this? By switching off fans and lights when not in use. Do not tear pages from the books borrowed from the library. Keep the books safely if you borrow them. You have to keep them safe as you keep your own books safely. Understood? Now, question number 5 is, why are monuments important? How should we care for them? Monuments are important because they are important sources of the past. They tell us about the events and happenings of the past. They are tourist spots also. We must not harm them by scribbling on their walls. We should not steal or pick up things from there. I hope all question answers are clear to you. Children, you have to memorize all the question answers, fill-ups and true-false, as well as match-ups, all the exercises I mean. Now wait for my next video. Till then, goodbye.